What a night that was.
Are they all gone?
Yes, and it's only 5 o'clock. We must be slipping.
Maureen, did you notice anyone who looked like a policeman?
In our audience?
You didn't.
Did you? What's wrong, Wendy?
Oh, that fellow was out there tonight.
Well, which one?
The one I told you about, Fox.
Oh.
He came in about 11. I was frightened at the way he was looking at me. So I rang the police and asked them to tell Sergeant Bronson. I suppose they thought I was mad.
Could be.
Look, I told you about him and Carol Weston.
Oh, yes, dear. Look, why don't you go home and take a couple of tablets?
Sorry, Maureen. I'll see you tomorrow night.
Here's a couple more.
Hi, everybody. We've come to help. Well, we did knock.
Well, that's all right. Just follow the screams of anguish.
Did he do it all by himself, Mr. Grosselk?
I regret to say I'm partly responsible.
But this week...
All right, all right. We know.
Sorry.
Well, don't just stand there. Do something.
Stay. Oh, I'm sorry, my dear. Not a very nice topic of conversation for the breakfast table.
You forget, Colonel, I'm a country girl.
Then we must start cutting lucerne by Monday at the latest.
You'll be busy.
It's that time of the year.
I shall be able to help.
No, no, you've given us enough of your time already, August. You've got the vineyard to think of.
The vineyard needs nothing so much as sunshine now, and that is up to the Lord.
You leave a lot to the Lord, August. I'm sorry.
You take...
Where are you off to?
Janet's taking the children to her mother's for a few days.
I thought I was going to have to look for another lift to work.
No, no, I'm just driving them to the station.
Have a nice trip.
Thanks, Mr. Ross. I'll sit in the back with the children.
Senior Detective Peters.
Mrs. Walker.
What can I do for you?
The hospital contacted us. They wondered why you hadn't been in to see your husband.
Huh?
There's some details they'd like to know about Mr. Walker that only you can supply.
So I should have gone, I suppose. I'll ring them. Will that do?
Mrs. Walker, would you mind telling us why you haven't been in to see your husband?
Yes, I would.
Why?
It's personal.
Look, we don't want to pry into your affairs unnecessarily, but a crime has been committed. Your husband...
You must know. I thought she'd be there.
She?
My husband was playing up. I wasn't going to my mother's for a holiday. I was leaving him.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It happens.
Do you know her name?
No, I don't. I only found out 2 days ago. But I know what she looks like.
Can you describe her?
Well, the photo wasn't very clear.
You've got a photograph?
Yes, of the two of them. Found it in the glove box of the car. He was stupid enough
Where's
to leave
Where's the photograph
it.
Now?
In there. Tore it up.
May we have it?
You can do what you like with it. Frank, now look what you've done.
What I've done? That's pretty good, that is.
Don't you have to slam the door like that?
No. How would you like me to slam it?
Don't be smart.
Don't mind if I eat, do you?
Here, yeah, I'll do it.
Don't strain yourself.
So when do you feel like eating anyway after last night?
What's it to you?
Look, don't you think Joe cares about you?
Big brother? He's only worried in case I spoil his respectable image.
You don't care about anyone, do you? Well, how do you feel about that little boy being killed?
Well, I suppose you think I did it.
Don't be silly.
How's my missus now?
Much better, thanks, lovey. But I'm worried about Frank.
What's he been up to now?
Just getting out of everyone's hair.
Look, why don't you wake up yourself?
It's about time you grew up.
Well, what do you want me to do?
Well, running away is not going to help.
All right. What?
Well, come and sit down. Let's talk it over.
Okay.
We passed through Sydney 6 years ago on our way up to the Gold Coast.
How long did you stay there, Mrs. Taylor?
We didn't. We had lunch in our caravan on the Pacific Highway, then drove on.
No calls on friends or relatives?
We don't have anybody up there. Mrs. Taylor, what can you tell me about your husband's work? Was he dented? He wasn't. I don't know. He's been there since school.
Getting ahead? Good prospects.
I hear he's very efficient. He should be in charge, not that stupid man Claiborne. Expected to be? He's entitled to it. Well, God knows how many nights he's worked back catching up on work that should have been done by Claiborne. He covers for him, carries him, out of loyalty to the firm. But does the firm ever consider him? Oh, never.
They must know this Claiborne's inefficient.
He's an old servant of the company, never gives any trouble. And in his gentle, cunning old way, keeps himself in the limelight whilst Ian does all the work. And when the firm's pleased, yes, I thought we should do it that way. And when they aren't pleased, I'll speak to Taylor. Can't have him doing that sort of thing. Well, there's politics. And they went too far. Finally drove him into hitting back. It was a violent reaction when it came, Mrs. Taylor.
$92,000 assaulting young Bryant.
And it was premeditated. He knew he was cutting himself off from his home, from you. You convinced my husband's a thief.
You told me you were very happily married.
We are.
If your husband did steal the money, it means he has to go on the run. He can't come back for you. Isn't that desertion? A choice? You owe the money. He may get in touch with you. Ask you to join him. The photograph, please.
Mr. Bell, you're an early bird.
Alec, please. After you left last night, another couple came back. They were very interested in becoming distributors.
Oh.
So I thought it only fair to come and see you first before I let anybody else have the dealership.
Well, that's very good of you. You must come in.
Thanks.
George is having his breakfast. You must take us as you find us. It's school holidays. We're in a bit of a mess.
So I said to myself, I know it's expensive, but why not?
It's a beautiful car.
It's the only way to travel, in comfort.
Not like our old bomb.
Must cost a bit to run.
Well, you can't let the tax man have it all.
Oh, this looks lovely. Have you seen it, George?
Hmm? What?
Florida. Look.
Oh, yeah.
Fantastic place.
You've been there?
Next month. All expenses paid by the company. Here's a couple of distributors who've been there already.
Oh, sounds wonderful, doesn't it?
Well, you can do it too. It's your choice.
Oh, I don't know.
Look, how many children do you have?
Oh, just the two.
Barbara's 12 and Brian's 10. And it's his birthday today.
Well, you want him to get on in the world, don't you? I mean, university education and all that. Well, it all costs money.
You certainly have a better chance than I did.
Right. Well, now, if you want him to have that chance, grab this opportunity. Well, borrow the money if you have to.
Well, there's no need for that. I got a bit in the bank.
Oh?
It's his workers' compensation.
Yeah, it came through a couple of months ago. We've always wanted to live in the country. At last, we were able to sell up and come here.
We hardly know anyone yet.
Oh, with us, you'll soon have hundreds of friends and be earning thousands of dollars.
I'd still like to think about it a bit.
Look, I tell you what. We're having a party for Brian this afternoon. Why don't you come back after that? It'll give us a chance to talk things over.
Well, I do have some other prospects to see today. I mean, once all the super generals are... Well, dealerships in this area are at a premium. You can't afford to turn this down.
They're terrors when they get going.
Half a Matlock's in there.
You must have your hands full. Can I do anything?
Oh, not really.
You sure?
Well, you could help me with these.
Right. Hundreds and thousands. My kids love them. It's amazing what they'll eat, isn't it?
Just got the two girls, have you?
Yes, and that's enough. What do you think of Matlock?
Well, we hardly know anyone yet. But it'll be nice once we get settled in.
Yeah, well, you've got the best months to come. Hills are beautiful in summer.
My husband loves the bush. You'll probably meet him. He's out getting more lemonade for that lot.
Once he got the day off?
No. We're going into business on our own, you see.
Oh.
Well, I think we are.
What sort of business?
Well, it's... No, I won't say anything in case it doesn't come off. It's awful when people tell you things and they never happen.
Well, she said she'd meet you here.
It's all right.
Well, what if you miss her?
We won't. We'll stay on the road.
And perhaps you should give her another 10 minutes.
We've waited ages already.
Mm, I suppose it's all right then. Are you sure you know the way?
Yes. Thanks for the party. Oh, yes, thanks for the party.
All that money, George. You can't afford to turn it down. Now, if you'll just sign here.
I'm not sure. I'd like to think about it a bit.
Now,
more.
That worries me, George.
Huh?
Well, it means I haven't done my job properly. Now, is there any little point that's bothering you? Something I can clear up?
I'll get it.
No, you seem to have covered everything.
Well, then.
All right. If you're sure.
Take my word for it.
They're in considerable danger, Mrs. Evans.
Dear, I should have kept them here.
Which way'd they go?
Oh, Paddy, love. I've got a splitting head.
We'll soon fix that. What's the trouble with you drinkers? No stamina.
Oh, how much did I drink?
Half a bottle of gin. Never mind, you've had a good rest.
What's the time?
About one.
Oh, damn. I've missed the shops.
Relax. It's all fixed.
Oh, thanks, love. You know, I feel worse than when I went to bed.
Oh, I'm wearing you out.
That'll be the day. Spend 3/4 of your life at sea.
I'm going to give it up.
Mm. Heard that one before, too.
No, as God's my witness, just one more sea trip, and I'll have my sea boots stuffed and mounted, and you can hang them over the bed.
Get out, you silly devil.
Look, I tell you what. Once you get dressed, we'll go to the footy this afternoon. We'll have a night out, nice quiet dinner, and a bottle of wine for yourself.
The dinner I'd love. The strongest thing I'm going to drink is coffee.
Just as you say, love.
Where have you been?
Like I told you, with a fella from the ship.
Was his name Miss Anderson? Oh, I worked out why I had a headache this morning. I was putting your clothes away and these fell out of the pocket. Miss L. Anderson, take 2 pills before retiring.
I found them.
Oh, can't you do better than that?
Well, you remember I went to the supermarket yesterday?
Yes.
Well, I found them on the floor.
Oh, bloody funny, you never mentioned it.
Well, I didn't think of them until I got home last night.
And I suppose when you finished doping me, you went and spent the night with this Anderson woman.
No, I didn't. You remember you wanted some coffee before you went to bed last night?
Yes.
Well, I made 2 cups and I wasn't feeling the best, so I thought I'd take a couple of them pills, and obviously I gave you the wrong cup.
Then you don't know Miss Anderson?
No, I don't. I swear by Almighty God, I never heard of Miss Anderson.
Sorry, Paddy.
Forget it. Silly old biddy.
Roberts forced Mr. Murphy to tell him where you lived.
Oh, God. What am I going to do, Sergeant?
Is your husband home?
He's outside working. But, well, I haven't told him about Glenn.
You better tell him then, and quickly.
I don't know how he'll react.
Well, he's a sensible bloke. Now, look. You can either lock yourselves in the house or drive to Burrabri Police Station. I'll notify them. But don't come into Matlock. You might run into Roberts on the way.
I see.
Sergeant Madden's on his way.
Thank you, Sergeant.
And you better hurry, Jenny.
All right.
What is it, Jen? Jen, for God's sake, what is it?
Something terrible's happened. Look, it was 8 years ago. I hoped you'd forgotten about it.
But you hadn't.
I tried to tell you, but...
Hey.
Hey, is this why you've been on my back to sell up and move out to Queensland?
Oh, Jen, you should have told me.
Would have saved a lot of arguments.
Oh, I'm sorry, Larry. Look, we'd better hurry.
No, Jen, no, I'm not running.
What?
Well, I'm not going to be driven out of my own home by an animal like Glenn Roberts. I'm your husband now. I'm going to protect you.
No, Larry. Look, the Burrabri police are expecting us.
I'm not running, Jen.
Well, you don't know what Glenn's like. He's violent. He enjoys hurting people.
He's flesh and blood. This is only single shopping it's going to have to do.
Larry.
Listen, he's not hurting you while I'm around.
Larry, let's just take the car, please, and go.
The police aren't even sure it's Roberts.
Oh, well, who else could it be?
Well, how the hell would I know? You don't tell me everything, do you? Sorry, Jen. I didn't mean that. You stay in the house.
I'll shoot.
Years for this. The only thing that kept me going was knowing that one day I'd be out again and I'd settle with you.
If you kill me, I'll put you away forever.
You gotta catch me first. Anyway, it'd be worth it just to know you're dead.
You must be mad!
No one dobbs me in and gets away.
Do it again. You should be locked up.
Won't do you any good even if I am. After I finish with you, I'm gonna take care of your husband. Think about that for a while.
And the trouble at home explains a lot.
Does it?
Well, he's a good boy, really, but totally undisciplined.
The absent father. Aren't most women expected to look after their kids on their own?
Yes, unfortunately.
Isn't that what school is for? To teach a child discipline?
I thought it was for education.
Of course, but this is
look,
also...
Mr. Peters, if you're trying to suggest that I'm to blame for what's
not.
Happened... I've got a class of over 30 children to look after, and at least 10 of them are Billy's.
All right, I'm not suggesting anything. All I'm saying is it's easy to blame the father. Usually there's more than one person at fault.
Except if Billy is lost. I know who his father's going to blame.
Thank you.
Mrs. Miller. Hello. Mr. Miller, isn't it? I'm Karen Marsh, Billy's teacher.
It's very good of you to come out and... Listen, you wouldn't have a cigarette, would you?
No, I'm sorry, I don't.
I seem to have left mine. You knew he came out here to play?
Well, we knew that some of the boys did.
Oh.
It's strictly out of bounds, of course.
I see.
Mr. Miller, if some of the boys come here after school, there's very little we can do about it.
Not your responsibility. Modern methods of education, I've heard all about them. Freedom of expression, lack of discipline, let the kids do whatever they like. It's great, though, if you're a teacher. Doesn't leave you with anything to do. The trouble is, you're not much more than bloody kids yourselves.
Look, I don't have to stand here.
I'll give you a due, though. You've got guts coming down here helping you look for him.
Mr. Miller, just because you're more intent on finding someone else to blame than you are in finding Billy, it doesn't mean to say that I'm here because I've got a guilty conscience.
What do you mean?
I won't say it's been a pleasure.
Frank, I was...
Keep coming, lady. Come on, move!
Please, do as he tells you.
Shut up! Get that by the back door. The next person who comes through there is going to get a little surprise.
What do you want?
Oh, just a bit of a breather. Neighbours and me, we're going to the procession. Where the fireworks man.
Catch it, lady. Don't be so bloody stupid, lady. Every cop in town knows where I am.
Used to get hold of a big cane coach from the sugar field. We'd draw a circle in the earth. Red dust, and we'd put them in the middle and fire slugs at them. The closer you planted the slug, the higher they'd jump. Unless, of course, you hit them.
What's going to happen to me?
I don't know. Haven't got around to that yet. Hey, how'd you like to see the procession? That's right, boys. Pour it on. More the merrier.
I can't go with you. I don't know how to drive. I can't go.
Oh, don't do the dirty on me now, Joyce. We're big news, you and me. The stars of the whole shebang.
City-bound drivers, I'm not going to hurt you. Proceed along Burke Road.
Just don't step on the toes on the way up to the truck.
City-bound drivers,
shut up.
Proceed along Burke Road and High Street.
Just calm down, will you? You'll be all right. Stay like that until it's time to go. You married, Joyce? Yeah. Your husband's name's Frank, huh? Yeah, and this your place. Where's Frankie?
Not here. He's gone to the TAP.
Poor old Frank. Just now all the fun. You love him? You love him? That's nice. Two people living together should love one another. Talk to one another. You know what I mean? Say nice things. Not treat you like you're a piece of bloody furniture, like a chair to be sat in. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Frank talk to you?
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice. What does he say? What does he say when you're in bed alone at night? What does he say?
He tells me that he loves me.
Oh, that's nice. Pity Frankie boy wasn't with us. We'd make a nice threesome.
Stay in your home. There is no cause for alarm.
Hey, use the back door.
Oh, no. I don't, please.
Then we'd see how far Frankie could jump, eh? Well, it's only a joke. This is a bad joke. Look, I'll move it back from the door so I can get in nice and easy.
Get the jelly. Come on, move, get the box.
Get over by the door.
Jim.
Tremendous, Al.
Bloody tremendous.
What does that mean that you...
What?
Chuck it in.
You've had a good spin, Al.
Oh, you too. You were there. You saw it. They couldn't touch me.
Look, you were bloody lucky.
Oh, like hell.
I'll go get the lunch. Well, I'm sorry he's gone to Sydney.
Oh, I see.
He flew up last night in business. Why, is anything wrong?
We just like to talk to him, that's all.
Heard that before.
What time do you leave, Mr. Salmon?
Shortly before 5. His plane left at 6.
Which airline?
I don't know. Look, he was acquitted, wasn't he? Can't you leave him alone?
You have a contact number for him in Sydney, Mr. Salmon?
No.
Where's he usually stay?
With his girlfriend.
You have her address?
No. Any more questions?
Mrs. Salmon, there's been a murder. An associate of your husband's.
Who?
I don't think you'd know him.
Who, damn you?
A man by the name of Lee. He's a witness in the trial against your husband.
Look, you don't think that...
We just want to talk to him, that's all.
Well, you'll just have to wait till he comes back then, won't you?
You have any idea where he is?
No.
Thank you, Mrs. Salmon. That's all for the moment.
Look, Al wouldn't kill anyone. Now, you know that, don't you, Mr. Banner?
Good afternoon, Mrs. Salmon.
When did it happen?
About an hour ago.
Where?
Port Melbourne, trucking company yard.
So he didn't go to Sydney. Did he kill that man, Mr. Peters?
We're not sure yet.
Why? When everything was going so right for him. Should never have got off those charges. God, it was obvious enough.
It's a technicality, really. Those things happen sometimes.
At least he'd still be alive. This man he's supposed to have killed. What had he done to Alan?
He gave us some information about your husband.
Is that all? So he killed him?
We think so.
God. He deserved to die, do you know that? He was no bloody good to anyone. Oh, you'll all be glad to have him out of your hair. And I tell you something. So am I. So am I. Do you think it was murder? I don't.
Al didn't have a gun, Jim.
For once. Ironical, isn't it? First he gets off those charges. And then he becomes the innocent victim of a deliberate homicide.
You don't exactly sound like you miss him.
He was a bastard and you know it.
What are you going to do now?
I don't know. Can't afford to stay here.
He wasn't insured?
And when did Al ever do anything for anyone but himself?
Well, I can let you have some.
Don't worry. I can manage.
Really, June, I'd like to. Look, I know it's a bit soon after everything, but... Well, I thought we might see a bit more of each other. That's all.
Jim, you're very sweet.
Believe me, I wouldn't do it just for you.
You're really taking over, aren't you? Al's business interests, as he liked to call them.
Oh. Well, on a much smaller scale.
Then I don't ever want to see you again, Jim. You were pretty well ironed out when you came to bed last night.
Yeah, was it ever?
Well, don't you think that... Jim, I can't remember the last time you went a whole day without a drink.
Don't you think that maybe, well, perhaps you're drinking too much?
I don't just think, I know it. I tell you what I'll do. Today's a dry day. Won't even touch the stuff. Tomorrow, too.
I better rush. I'll be late for work again.
Leave those things, I'll do them.
Well, I'll leave them, but don't you do them. You know, when you break into your work, you'll never get started again. I'll do them tonight, okay?
Okay.
Off you go. Good luck.
Yeah.
Jim. The police were here.
What were they doing here? What did they want with you?
Well, they just wanted to know what time you got home Wednesday night, things like that. The way they were acting, it was as though they thought you killed Ralph.
I know. Been with them all day. No way. Just don't worry. Everything's all sorted out now.
Why would anyone want to take his wallet and then throw it away with the money still in it?
Oh, look, well, I don't know. We've been over this about 10 times. Couldn't we talk about something else?
You all right, Jim?
Yeah, I'm just a bit upset, that's all. What about you? How was work today?
Not too bad.
Come on, what's the matter?
Well, I had another one of those turns. You know, dizzy spells. Look, Jim, I know we'd planned for me to work another fortnight, but I just don't think I'm going to be able to. It's not the work so much as the travelling. Means this the tram ride and then that long uphill walk from the tram stop to the office.
Oh, that's it then. Finish. As of now, you phone them up in the morning, tell them you won't be in.
But what about your book?
Oh, we've got enough money to last us for 3 weeks.
But that's to pay for the hospital and everything.
Well, if I can get 8 or 9 chapters done, they'll advance me some money as against royalties. That'll give us more than enough for the medical expenses and it'll leave me some for writing.
Can't write 8 chapters in a fortnight.
Yes, I can.
Now, let's face it, Jim. Now, look how much you've done in 6 months.
You're as bad as the rest of them. A little bit of faith in me wouldn't go astray.
Now, you know I've got faith in you. But that money was for the baby.
I've told you I'll get an advance.
If you write 8 chapters, I'll be reasonable.
All right. I'll bloody show you. Chapter 1. 2,000 words. I'll finish it tonight.
Oh, Jim.
You don't believe me? I'll prove it to you.
Help you?
Oh, excuse me, I was told I could pick up my son here.
Mrs. Simpson, is it?
Miss.
Well, how do you do? Come inside. Your little boy will be here in a minute. Hot weather we've been having. Still, to be expected this time of the year.
You must think I'm a rotten mother.
Oh, no.
Well, yes, you must. Joey's on holidays and I gotta go to work. He's by himself all day.
Couldn't he stay with friends?
You're all away. On the beach, in the bush. We got a flat, you know, quite neat and clean. Couldn't afford it just on social welfare.
Joe's mother, Tinky.
I've been so worried, Joe. I'm sorry, love.
So low one.
can be a little devil.
Don't worry. I'll manage.
Mrs. Birch?
Ah, good day.
How are things working out?
No complaints, Joe.
Hey, would you like to stay for a week?
I reckon you could give me a hand. What do you say? Is the deal?
Sure is.
That's settled then.
You're a lucky young fella.
I'll pick you up, Santi.
I don't want to leave this house. Ever.
What a beautiful morning. Sleep well? Much too long. It's been a lovely weekend. I was going to make Ben a cup of tea, but I can't find any milk.
There isn't any, I'm afraid. Milk can't strike or something. Oh, there's some condensed in the cupboard.
Thanks.
He's going, Mary. He's decided. We talked it over last night. Well, actually, he did all the talking.
Dorothy? I'm
not a very good communist, am I? I don't want him to go. I don't know how to stop him.
I'd feel the same if it was Ben.
Police. Monica Rourke. Rhoda? Who did it?
Duty orderly to the reception area, please. Duty orderly.
What the hell's she doing here?
Mr. Stewart, please.
I want her out of here, and I want her out of here now.
Be quiet and get out.
You've got no right being here upsetting my wife.
Your wife?
We've lived this man and wife for years, and I'm not having you.
Sister? I want to talk to him.
All right, dear, all right.
What is it, love?
Alone. Well, if that's what she wants.
I'll be just outside if you need me, Rhoda.
Want you something? Love, I'm sorry. Oh, I'm sorry. Forgive me.
Doug? Get rid of that young bitch. We go back to what we were. And I saw nothing.
You slept. Well, I promise.
Straight away?
Straight away.
Then I never saw who hit me. Fetch the policewoman.
Yeah?
Doug, it's Rhoda. Listen, sister said I could go home this hour after the doctor's done his rounds.
Oh.
About four? You pick me up?
I'll be tied up with a bloke. Well, it's important, but now hang on. Any chance of you picking up Rhoda this hour?
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, Joey, I'll pick you up.
I'll try. Dad? Is she gone?
Yeah, she's gone. Yeah. See you then.
Realise that by swearing a false statement to protect Stuart, you make yourself an accessory to the murder of Cornish.
I didn't lie.
Tell the truth and clear yourself.
What I said was the truth.
We are just about to crack this case wide open. This is your last chance to get out from under.
I am not lying.
What are the police?
Oh, Dawson, I think he said. He's in there now.
You're gone, son. Finished.
Well, what are we going here for?
Trying to pick up something for Doug.
Out!
Holy!
Nobody's gonna help you. You should have quit when you had the chance. When he belted you.
What are you talking about?
What happens if the cops find out about the 16,000 you owe?
I've been thinking about that. You know how Carter operated, always stayed within the law when he had to. The only records he kept were in his head.
So?
No one ever signed anything to acknowledge the loan we got. The money was paid to me in cash. I paid his interest each month in cash, no receipts asked, no receipts given.
Well, what are you getting at?
Well, he kept it quiet to dodge the tax man. Probably only us and him knew.
You mean now there's only us?
Carter's got no family.
Is that why you never let on to the cops why Carter came to see you this morning?
Give them a good reason to start digging, and they'd dig all right. We don't want them doing that, do we?
No, I don't suppose we do.
I think we'd take the risk and forget the loan, at least until somebody asks.
Vic, you want me to get lunch?
No, it's all right, Speed. I'll get it. Did you notice anyone waiting across the street when you came in?
No. Why? Claudia reckons someone's keeping an eye on the place.
What, cops?
Didn't look like them.
Did they say anything about not leaving the place?
Well, they said they'd be in touch again.
I got a mate up on the Gold Coast. Claudia and I are going to go up there.
Okay, I'll get fresh in that.
What do you got to run away from? Just until things quiet down. When the cops get someone, you can come up here.
Well, what about the gym?
Well, Speed can look after things. See, that's the one that followed me.
We'd like a word with you, Mr. Bishop.
Sure. It's private. Do you mind? I just thought you'd like to know that now that Mr. Carter's dead, I'll be looking after his interests. And his interest with you was by way of a loan, I believe. Is that right?
It did help me out with a few dollars.
$20,000, he told me.
Rubbish.
Mr. Carter told me $20,000. Did he tell you $20,000, John?
$20,000.
Look, Bishop, if we're going to work things out, make things balance, and I'm sure that's what Mr. Carter would have wanted, we're going to have to collect $20,000.
Can't get it.
Well, that's all right. We don't want it straight away. We'll be back at 5 this afternoon.
Well, I can't.
We'll be back at 5.
Oh, what on earth are you doing up at this ungodly hour?
It's not that early, is it?
It's not even 7 yet.
An early start won't hurt me for once.
Oh, it's the middle of the night.
Flick the radio on, will you? Might as well get the early news.
Glad you're spending the morning with us this morning. All right, nobody move, nobody will get hurt.
What the hell?
Sit down and shut up. Watch it.
What do you want?
We want to make a substantial withdrawal from your bank, Mr. Curran. And you're going to be our guarantee to see we get satisfaction.
You're wasting your time. I can't open the safe, it needs two.
Well, who's got the other one? Look, before I blow your head off, Curran, you'll watch her die.
The accountant.
Hey, now you're getting smart. Ring him. And don't try any heroics. My mate's staying here with your wife. If anything goes wrong at the bank, she cops it, understand?
Brian, it's Ralph. Listen, Brian, I'd like to get an early start, and there are a couple of files I need from the safe. Well, I'd like to get cracking right away if I could. No, there's nothing wrong. I meant to tee it up with you last night at the pub, but it slipped my memory. All right, I'll see you there in about 10 minutes.
Right, let's get moving.
You're not to worry, love. Just stay calm, do as they say, everything will be all right.
Mitch will be getting worried if we don't get a move on.
Yeah, move.
You harm her or not?
You what, Curran? Now move.
May I get a cup of tea, please?
No.
Well, can I have a glass of water?
paid. Time you got dressed, lady.
First picked up the scissors, you had no intention of stabbing Bill Jackson.
That's right.
Well, what did you intend to do with them?
I meant to stab her.
What made you change your mind?
It wouldn't have done any good. He still wouldn't have wanted me.
That's why you stabbed him.
Yeah. Well, you don't know what it's like, do you? Locked up night after night without a man. Thanks to you, I'm about to find out.
That's enough, Meg.
What do you mean, that's enough? It was my husband who was killed. I'm at least entitled to my say.
I said that's enough. Miss Bennett, take Mrs. Jackson out.
Meg, you're right.
Oh, fine. Just fine.
Well, at least now you know who did it.
What difference will that make? Will it bring Bill back?
Well, no, but every time you have to deal with one of the girls, you won't be wondering whether she was the one.
That doesn't alter the way I feel one little bit. They all knew who did it. But did any of them come forward? No, not one. Instead, they tortured, they terrorized her. They probably would have killed her if we hadn't stopped them. But they still wouldn't tell us why. No, oh, they're worse than animals.
You know, if they hadn't scared us, she'd never have confessed. We wouldn't have been able to prove a thing. Stay with Latham, would you? I'm going to arrange to have her transferred to another prison. We'll keep her in solitary until she's moved. We can't ensure her safety here.
Oh, yes, we must look after her safety, mustn't we?
You know I was born in prison.
And like Sam, I was taken away when I was one, too. And that was during the war. Well, I was sent to an orphanage. Things were much stricter in those days, and I didn't see my mother until she was released. By then I was six. It was too late for her. She wasn't fit to be a mother. That's what they said. She used to visit me every Sunday. I used to live for those Sundays.
What happened to her?
Well, one day she just didn't arrive. Found out 2 years later she died.
Oh, didn't they tell you?
Probably thought it was best I didn't know.
Haven't you ever had a home, Mrs. Jackson?
Well, by then I was 12. It was a bit late to be adopted.
Well, what about your dad?
He was killed in the war. What are you doing in here?
I just brought some cleaning nappies.
Well, hurry up then.
Well, let me tell you something about myself that'll add to your sense of superiority. I was born in prison. My mother was a criminal. One of the animals. So if you want to look down at me, Vera, you go right ahead. But it doesn't bother me in the slightest. Because I feel sorry for you. Really sorry.
Good morning, Meg. Vera. Have I interrupted anything?
No.
Believe what I'm seeing. You, be out before I come back down here. I'll be speaking to your father about you. You don't deserve a trip to Italy. In fact, I'd like nothing better than to leave you behind. That's out of the question now. Who knows what you'll get up to?
Giving you up was the hardest decision I've ever had to make in my life. Hardly a day's gone by since then that I haven't thought about you. I want to show you something. And please, don't think it's corny. I knitted these for you when I was pregnant, and I was never given the chance to give them to you. Considered having children because my family, the family who raised me, are muscular dystrophy carriers. I thought I was too. And now? Now I don't want kids. When I found out I was adopted, Bill started at me to have a family. Why don't you? Look at us.
Margaret, there were traces of ecstasy found in your husband's bloodstream.
What?
We're having problems establishing where it might have come from, and we need to eliminate the possibility that someone gave it to him surreptitiously.
You're suggesting I killed him?
No, not at all.
Why on earth would you think I'd do a thing like that? Because of his affair with Catherine Shepherd. Yes, yes, I knew everything. And about Jessica.
Ms. White, where did you go after you left the hotel yesterday morning?
Home. I had some phone calls to make. Robert was offered a place in the ministry once. Did you know that?
Yes, yes, there was some talk. Mm.
He had differences with the Premier and didn't want to be bound by cabinet confidentiality. Oh, if there was ever a time I could have killed him, that would have been it.
So why didn't you leave then?
Didn't need the grief. We had a comfortable arrangement, and I'd started pinning my hopes on Bobby.
Ah, just finished my shift, Dad. I thought I'd tag along.
Well, I'll be right. Carrie's got everything ready.
Well, yeah, I'm sure. But you'll need help with your medicine and comfortable bed. I'm the world's best bed maker.
Well, I couldn't possibly expect you to nurse me.
I'm the world's best nurse.
But I don't want you to.
Oh.
If I need a nurse, I'll hire one.
Righto, then you won't be needing me then.
Of course I will. You can do something for me that no one else can. You can be my sister. And that's something I've wanted my whole life. Thank you. It's all used to be on paper. The hours we used to waste. It's all been digitized now, of course. Uploaded or downloaded or whichever direction it goes in. No need for all those bits and pieces of paper we used to have. Or even microfiche. Just give me a 5 gig flash drive any day. Now, here we are, Mitzios. Computer says no. No applicants under that name.
So the letter's false. How come whoever wrote it knew your name?
Patience, young man. That's applicants. Let's try respondents. Yes, here we are. Oh, the mother's name was Sula, right?
Yes.
A scan of her original letter. Oh, she refused to have her details divulged to the applicant.
Applicant? Sorry, I don't understand.
Sula Mitzios wrote to us saying she didn't want her child to know who she was. Now, that's a birth mother's prerogative.
Hang on a sec. The birth mother? So she hadn't adopted her son?
No, not at all. She'd adopted a child out. The child was applying to locate her.